Welcome to the show floor at Google Cloud Next. My name is Jesse Nowlin. Today I have with me Googler David Rosenthal, friend of the community, joining me to discuss all things Starline. We'll get into what Starline is in a moment, but first, David, you're the go-to-market lead for Google's Project Starline. First of all, welcome to the show and thanks for coming on.
Thanks very much. You know, it's funny, Jesse, when I introduce you as friend of the realm.
Thank you. Yes, I feel like I need a cloak and a staff. And
absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. So for the audience, my name is David Rosenthal. I've been at Google for about 7 years, and I work on Project Starline that we're here to talk about today.
Apologies for the interruption in the video, but at least I'm doing it in a picturesque location. Hopefully this is a nice, serene, relaxing moment for you. But I have to talk about Movebot. I have here with me Colin from Movebot, who's the sponsor of this channel, longtime friend of the channel, and who without, I would not be able to do most of the videos, or if not any of the videos. So thank you very much for your support. Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much, Jesse. It's an absolute pleasure to be here.
Why don't you tell us a bit about Movebot?
Sure. So Movebot is basically a next-gen data migration platform. If you want to move data into Google Workspace or between Google Workspaces, you know, tenant to tenant, we have a fully scalable product. You don't have to worry about setting up any infrastructure. We can connect over 30 different platforms. Really easy to use. And, it should be for sort of Google to Google migrations or migrations into Google, really point, click and go. And honestly, as simple as that.
It is super simple. Fantastic. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Jesse. Thank you.
Amazing. And I had a experience in Starline a little bit before. We'll get into that. But for those who aren't familiar with this, why don't you give us a history rundown? What is Starline?
Got it. Okay. So Project Starline is a project that has been coming out of Google Labs for the past 4 or 5 years. Started out as a bit of an experiment, and it is Google's foray into three-dimensional video conferencing. Three-dimensional video conferencing, and I might add, without the usage of a headset or any glasses, you walk into a room, you look at what you think is a standard video conferencing kit, and all of a sudden the people on the far end appear to you in 3D.
So are we talking holograms, Star Trek level stuff? What do we got?
So I can't really get into the underlying technology. But it is definitely not a hologram. No, what you're actually looking at is what your brain thinks is a three-dimensional full motion image. Mm-hmm. And it does this without any headsets and without any external manipulation that would be a hologram or anything. So definitely not a hologram.
Right. And what was the beginning of this? Where was Google was like, hey, video conferencing sucks, even though we're a leader in video conferencing, let's make it better?
So originally it started out on the team that did Google Glass, and it was a headset. And we brought it out, talked to a few people about it, and everybody was like, oh, that's amazing, except for the headset.
Right.
So the problem then was to solve, right, how do we have that headset 3D experience without the headset? Mm-hmm. So there's a lot of math, a lot of science, a little bit of money, and a whole lot of really smart people working on this project.
Yeah, no, definitely. And I've seen a lot of the news about it over the years and that they've been working on it. And it's super under wraps. Even I wasn't allowed to go in and film what I experienced. I know that MKBHD, YouTuber Marquez Brownlee, did get a whole behind the scenes thing where he was allowed to film. I'm a little bit jealous.
You know, the first rule about Project Starline is you don't talk about Project Starline. So we're under a press blackout right now, just for, in terms of the physical form factor and all the types of things that go along with launching a hardware product. I assure you that once the reveal moment happens, that the gloves will be off in terms of allowing you in to film and capture all of those images.
And you're going to hit me for this, but are we barreling towards that? Are we close to a release date? What's going on?
Yeah, 100%. So here's what I can tell you from a timeline perspective. So number one, the product will launch this year, right? So we're talking about second half of 2025. Okay. So that's number one. Number two, there'll be an announcement shortly. We haven't picked a launch moment yet. Or if we have picked the launch moment, I can't tell you about it. But I can tell you that it's going to be soon. Mm-hmm. And then we'll be announcing what the exact launch date is. Pricing, availability, geos, all the sort of things that come along with a market launch of a device.
Right. Now, this is not something that goes in the laptop. yet?
No, 100%. So this is a Project Starline is a purpose-built piece of hardware combined with software. We have partnered with HP as the manufacturing partner for the first Starline device. Mm-hmm. That will be rolling off the assembly lines when it rolls off the assembly line, the date that I can't tell you.
Later this year.
Later this year. Yeah, absolutely. And so the go-to-market model is really HP manufactures and distributes the hardware, and then we have a component of cloud software that performs the 3D rendering and projection.
Mm-hmm. Now, in my experience, it's a whole, I'll put a picture up on the screen here, but it's a whole booth-like setup. Is HP, I use a lot of the other HP products in conference rooms of clients of mine and whatnot, and the experience is fantastic. It integrates with Google Meet and other platforms, etc. Am I going to need to put a closet in my conference room?
No, I think our goal here is to be able to use conference rooms that exist already. I mean, there are going to be some limitations, right? It's a one-to-one experience, so you're not going to want to put it in a room, say, this size. Mm-hmm. But we're really targeting small, medium-sized conference rooms. So definitely conference rooms that exist already. No, you're not going to be able to put it in your closet, but our expectation is that it will be in small, medium-sized conference rooms. That pre-exist.
Right. And what is it running on? Is it its own dedicated platform, or is it Google Meet? How does that work?
Gotcha. So a lot of these questions I can't answer right now, but I can tell you a couple of different things.
Okay.
So number one is our launch product will be running on Google Meet, so mm-hmm. for workspace customers. Number two is we have announced I think about 6 months ago that we will be implementing the Starline product on Zoom. We do not have a release date there. It will be sometime after the first availability of the first Starline product.
Okay, that makes a lot of sense. I mean, Google's been really good with Interop, with the different products that are out there, working together with the Google Meet platform and interoperability into Zoom and all of the other platforms that are out there. So it's good to see that everyone's still playing nicely together.
Yeah, it's really important. And I think COVID really helped that. Pre-COVID, all the video platforms were really islands amongst themselves. And I think the entire ecosystem started to understand how important it is to be able to use, your non-primary video solution on a variety of different devices. I think this was driven by, sort of the massive improvements in the guest experiences of all the primary video platform vendors. And I think, we really are reaping the benefits now.
All right. Okay. Yeah, I love it. Now, we're here at Google Cloud Next. That's why it's so loud. There's somebody with another microphone system over there who's doing something, some kind of game show, I guess, going on. But I got to try it.
Yes, you did. What'd you think?
Honestly, this cannot come soon enough.
Yeah, I know. It's amazing. The first time I saw the product, I was just like, I was like, how can we make this the standard?
Bastard.
Yeah. I think the... we've been working video projects together for a long time, right? And I think the video industry as a whole kind of thinks about how do we make video, how do we add features? How do we make it more convenient? How do we make it work on more devices? And what I think Project Starline actually challenges is the notion that video cannot be as good as real life. And I think you experience that, right? You sort of know it's mm-hmm. not real life, but you sort of have to really pay attention.
Right. Now, just to walk everybody through kind of my experience, you go into this booth and it's as if you're sitting down at a desk for a one-on-one conversation, as if somebody was sitting in front of me, but it's a screen. And initially I was just going, well, okay, what's going on? And then the call starts and it looks like the person is sitting across from me and not on a flat screen somewhere. And then they, as the call goes on, they go to hand me an apple. And instinctively, I reached out to take it.
Yeah, totally. And and right, you know it's not there.
I know it's not
right.
There.
You walked into the room. There was no apple there.
There's nothing there. It's a screen.
Yeah, exactly. And that's part of the magic. And we really do view it as as magic. So what we want, for the long term, right, the long vision is that becomes kind of the premium standard for video conferencing.
Right. And I remember the years ago with the Kinect, that was a PrimeSense company, I think. And then Kinect was the 360 body motion technology that was in the Xbox 360, I think it was. That tech is now so small, it powers Face ID in the iPhone.
Yep.
How long do you think it's going to take until we get there with this? I want it in my laptop.
Yeah, I don't know. There's a fair amount of, sort of just raw material limitations.
Sure.
In terms of how we get that experience that are not all that reasonable to put on a laptop. But what we're seeing is, just from an ecosystem perspective, that companies like HP and companies like Dell are bringing the next generation of 3D monitors to the market. Mm-hmm. So we can imagine a world where these things come together. We don't know what that is right now, but we're hoping that the technology becomes pervasive because the experience is amazing.
Certainly. Well, like any new project, I've been testing out for work augmented reality and virtual reality headsets and not quite goggles, but glasses. Recently, I've been using the X-Real lineup of glasses as a external display. I don't need to bring a secondary monitor with me when I travel anymore because it's on my face. That being said, even the resolution in those glasses, it's still grainy. It looks like an older generation iPhone or Android phone where you can actually see the pixels on there. And this was a little bit like that. It had a little bit of graininess to it. I understand it's been improved, it's getting better, but this is still very early for this tech.
Yeah, very early. And our goal is to keep incrementally making this product better, getting closer and closer to real life.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so who is going to be buying this when it launches later this year? Are we going to have this in all businesses or looking at,
everybody? Everybody. No, we think about this a lot. So when we think about the primary launch use cases for Project Starline, we definitely think about a couple of different areas. So number one was executive communication. So Executive communications is the CEO talking to their SVP level. We're talking about CEO to board, private equity, venture capital, titans of industry, masters of the universe, that type of, that type of high stakes conversation. But as we were, kind of iterating on what that use case looks like, the other area that is always a high stakes use case is people operations or human resources.
Right.
So when we think, if you make a right hiring decision, that pays back dividends, in the future. If you make a wrong one, it's almost worse.
Mm-hmm.
So making sure that experience in the form of recruiting, interviewing, hiring, onboarding, firing, when I get fired from Google, I want to get fired on Starline, right?
Okay.
That'll definitely, smooth out the edges a little bit. So we think about that use case as well, as kind of the primary use cases. And then there's a catch-all of just general VC replacement in small conference rooms. And that's kind of what we know. And then there's the whole world of things that we don't know.
Right.
Right. What does this look like for, telemedicine? So we know that there are some, obviously technical limitations to put this on a rounding cart in a hospital, but could you use it for mental health? I could use it for mental health, man.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm already getting advertisements for a couple of providers through my healthcare. Through my health insurance that want to do virtual telehealth where I just use my phone, and this would be so much more impactful, I think.
Yeah, exactly. There's a level of connection that you get on Starline that, just makes any of that experience better. So one thing, just to sort of hop back to human resources, right? We know that there's a case where people are bad interviewers on the phone or on video, but they're great interviewers in person. Maybe this will help, hiring committees hire better people because you can get a true view of the person's capabilities. And along those lines, mental health, right? There are, going to be some people that don't want to have a, emotional conversation with their therapist, right, on a pixel phone.
Yeah, I know for sure. So I'm envisioning future WeWork offices with a bunch of these booths, and it's like, okay, come to your interview with Google at WeWork in the booth.
Right, 100%. Or think about maybe Starline on a trailer rolling up to MIT or Stanford or, whatever. Not that we're elitist. graduation days,
right.
and
community college works too.
and that sort of experience. So we're super excited about that.
Okay, amazing. And I had another question that I forgot where I was going with it. Honestly, this personally experiencing it, not a lot of people have gotten that opportunity. A lot of people here are going to try it out.
But I do agree, I think that we're headed towards something really special here, that you're going to get that human to human, as if we're next to each other now, interaction. And it's so great that that came out of COVID, because that was what we were all so desperately looking for.
Yeah. The only two things that came out of COVID, right? Everybody knows how to make sourdough, and video conferencing has gotten so much better. On the experience for Starline, so we're here at Cloud Next. We'll be at a variety of cloud summits in mostly in Europe this summer and this fall. We'll be at Infocom. We will be at most large Google events. So please, if you're around, drop by the Starline booth and sign up for a demo.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, this is my personal take here, but next year at Next, we're going to have a presentation on the stage. It'll just be Starline. Sundar won't be here. He'll be virtual. Or just, you know, sell your stock in your airlines and buy Google instead.
Who knows?
My opinions, not the opinions of Google. We're getting the notice to wrap up over here. So we got a couple more minutes. Is there anything else that you want to share with the folks out there?
Let me see. What did we not hit on? So maybe the relationship with HP, right? Why did we select HP as the manufacturing partner for the first Starline device? I think a couple of different reasons. Number one, they're quite good at manufacturing, right?
Yep.
Obviously. They're excellent because of the Poly acquisition. They're excellent at audio.
Yep.
I feel like we've talked about this before, that you can have a moderate quality video meeting and it's sort of okay, but if you have bad audio, everybody hates it.
Right.
So it's really important, and I think HP brings that that focus on audio quality. They've got a great sort of channel program and go-to-market motion because of their video bar portfolio.
Yep.
And let's not forget what a key partner they are on the Chromebook. So I think all of these things sort of played into the decision to select them as the initial partner for Starline devices.
Yes, definitely. No, that makes a lot of sense. And I have actually had some folks on their team on the show before talking about their devices. They're good friends of the Works with Chrome program, and I love their Chromebooks. And they killed my favorite one, but, you know, can't win them all, I suppose. And hopefully there'll be more new ones that'll become my new favorite that are coming down the road. We're not here to talk about
them. Yeah, I hope so, too. I'm on my first Chromebook, and I actually am quite delighted.
Which one?
The Dragonfly.
I love the Dragonfly.
Yeah.
Well, hopefully soon in the not-too-distant future, we'll have Starline on Dragonfly. And
who knows
where it's going to go. All right, we're going to wrap there. Thanks, folks, for joining us. This has been an absolute blast from Google Cloud Next. David, thank you for coming on the show.
Jesse, thanks so much. Always a pleasure.
Always a pleasure.
Bye.